In this video, we'll try to understand how we can create input parameters for SQL Server Reporting Services report. What do I mean by that? In our previous lab, we displayed a simple country report, and which actually displayed all the country name and country ID. Right now, what if I want to go and put a simple text box here, where a person can go and type the country name and he can find the data, right? So for those kind of scenarios, we need to go and create an input parameter. Now, in order to create an input parameter, click on view and click on report data. Now, once you click on report data, you will be popped up, with a report data explorer, which actually has lots of folders like built-in fields, parameters, images, data sources, and data set. Expand the data set. Now, this data set is nothing but, basically this is the person who actually fetches data inside your SQL Server Reporting Services report, right? So if you want to create an input parameter, we need to go and modify this data set. Okay. So currently we have only one data set, that is data set one, which actually has two fields. One is country ID and country name. So this is the country ID and this is the country name, right? So right click on this data set one and click on query. Now that goes and pops up a query designer window. So currently we want to go and search on country name, right? So what we'll type over here is we'll say here where country name is equal to @ country name. So this @ country name, it's nothing but it's an input parameter which we expect from the SSRS report. Okay, so if you see the previous SQL, it was only this much. There was no where clause, right? Now because we want to have a search on the country name, so we have to put a where clause and we have to say where country name is equal to @ country name. Okay, if you do okay, now what happens is, you will see that in the parameters folder, it has automatically created a parameter called as country name, right? So now if I go to my report over here, let me just do a save over here. Memory is corrupt. What is that? Very stupid error. Gosh. Okay, let me just go and run that. That was a strange error. Let me build it. Okay, we can just excuse the memory error. I've never seen it, so leave it. Okay, now if I go and do a preview over here, you can see that he has automatically created a country name text box over here, right? And if I go and type IND and if I do a view report, it should actually just show me the IND record, and that's working, right? If I say USA, right? So in other words, in order to go and add an input parameter to your reporting services report, what you need to do is click on view, click on report data, right click, go and modify your query and put the parameter with the @ sign, which will automatically go and create the parameters in the parameter folder, and that parameter would be displayed into the preview over here. Now you can see that this is country name over here, right? So in case you want to put some nice name over here like search by country name, right? So what you can do is view report data, right click, properties, parameter properties, and I'll say in the prompt, saying search by country name. And you can also say that, okay, do not allow blanks, do not allow null values, etc., right? So I'm going to do okay over here. Now if you see in the search here, you can see that this is search by country name. Now let us go ahead and complicate this input parameter situation a bit. So you can see that I have a very simple table here which is displayed on SSRS screen, which has country name, customer name, gender, email, married, right? And it has three or four records here. And one of the field here is country name. So I would like to go and search by country name on this, but what I would like to do is I don't want such kind of a text box field, but I want a drop down. Okay, so I would like to have a drop down here with all the country names, that is India, USA, Nepal, and when the end user goes and selects the country, right, accordingly the data should be displayed on the screen. So let's go ahead and try to create an input parameter which is a drop down rather than a text box, right? So again the steps are all same. So click on view, click on report data, right click, query. Now you can see that actually, you know, this country name is nothing but, you know, it is taken from this country master table here. So you can see there's an inner join here, but we are interested to search by country name, right? So I'll say here where country name, again I need to put a qualifier here, so country master dot country name, country master dot country name is equal to @ country name. I'll say okay, and once I say okay, you can see the country name field in the parameters folder here, right? And if I go to the preview now, you know, it is actually a text box. So we don't want this as a text box, right? We want it as a drop down. So let's again go back, switch to design, right click on this country name parameter. Let's go to parameter properties, and over here let's select allow multiple values. And now let's go back to available values menu here. So let's go to the available values menu, and over here we'll say specify value. So first one is India, second is Nepal, and third is USA, right? So now if I go and do a preview over here, so now you can see there's a drop down. So if I say India, it will actually show me India, right? If I say here Nepal, shows me Nepal, right? So the first scenario we had a very simple text box as an input parameter, and in the second scenario now we have a drop down, you know, which will help us to go and select the values from a drop down, right? So I hope that you enjoyed this video. So in this video we were trying to understand how we can create input parameters for our SQL Server reporting services, and we saw two examples. One is we created an input parameter which is a text field, and other one is we created an input parameter which is a drop down. Thank you so much.